final year of college or open the first play. I've been writing since I was a child, though. I suppose it was in the family, it was in the air. I come from a family of writers, so that would always have been an influence, I suppose. The thing about the Windham-Campbell Prize is you don't know that you're up for it unless you win it, which is really nice. There's nothing circusy about it, nothing of the circus about it, you're not paraded anywhere. So you are, your work is put forward. So I'm not even sure which of my plays were put forward, probably the whole body of work. I presume they look at that. They did single out some of the plays and spoke about them, so maybe they read sample plays. And it's very nice because you get a phone call to be told you've won this prize and you have no idea that you're even up for it. I feel very happy. It's kind of a public validation of the work, which is always nice. I feel very grateful because there, you know, the world is full of excellent writers. The competition is fierce, and to be chosen in this instance, often you're not chosen, but sometimes lady luck shines on you or smiles on you. So I feel very happy about it. I'm working on a play for the Tricycle Theatre in London, which is based on Clytemnestra, who was the wife of Agamemnon, which is the queen of Mycenae. So I'm working on that, that's really finished. And I'm also working on a piece, an adaptation to The Lighthouse by Virginia Woolf. And I'm working on several things. I'd be moving backwards and forwards on several things. This is a play called Hecuba, and it's about the Queen of Troy after the Trojan War, after she's lost everything. So here she is in the throne room. So I'm in the throne room, surrounded by the limbs, torsos, heads, corpses of my sons. My women trying to dress me, blood between my toes, my son's blood, six of them, seven of them, eight. I've lost count. Not that you can count anyway, they're not complete. More an assortment of legs, arms, chests. Some of the armor still on, some stripped. Hands in a pile, whose hands are they? Ears missing, eyes hanging out of sockets, and then Andromache comes in screaming, holding this bloody bundle. My grandson, intact except for his head, smashed off a wall like an eggshell. They're through the south gate, she says. They've breached the citadel. They're here. I say, put him with the rest, put him beside Hector, his father's mangled body. She won't stop screaming. Shut up, I say, he'll draw them on us. I tell the women to cover her mouth. We have no soldiers to protect us, all dead. They're still fighting, trying to save their own women and children. And I don't know where Priam is. He went out a while ago. When was